Think of parents who have a child. is more than anything, will be Amelia and Jade. Amelia and Jade and often about Julie. You maybe better than anybody know what love is. You know what it is to be cared for, to have somebody there who loves you and looks out for you and wants only the best for you. And what do you know that only too well? And sometimes you might get cross with mom or dad, wouldn't you? And ready to say that the worst in the world. But you know you are the luckiest people to have a mom and dad who really love you and will do everything possible for you. And where you feel safe. And that is what Sarah and John have in John. You will hear later on, I'm sure, the sad tale, if you haven't already heard it, of how they met and got to know each other. And how Sarah, over time, wore John down. Said, okay. But isn't that the most wonderful feeling? To know there's somebody who's right for you. Another person is perfect. If we're looking for perfection, we are in serious trouble. But looking for the person who's right for you, where you can just be yourself. So often in life, we have to play a role. We have to wear a mask. And we can't reveal and disclose what our real true thoughts and feelings are. And that is necessary if we're to live in some sort of civilized, safe society. But you need a space and a place where you don't have to wear the mask, where you can be yourself. And that is why we celebrate today the same job, that you are right for each other. And, we are all called to have love and respect, and to have love and care for people wherever they are, particularly those who are in any sort of trouble, be they in our family, our neighborhood, our all kinds of work. But most of all, we're called to show what is most beautiful in us to our own family and our closest friends. Always we should preserve what is most beautiful in us for those nearest to us. And my prayer today is that you would have one of those special days. But this place will always be a place that brings you happy thoughts and memories. The place you'll come back to many times, I hope too. But that is a day that marks the beginning of a new phase in your life. You already made this commitment. Today you are celebrating it. May you dance together in many, and may all of them be truly happy. Amen. Sarah, do you still want to go ahead with this? Last time, this is the nearest we are. I invite you to come forward and make these marriage vows, please. Sarah and John, you come here to Holy Trinity Abbey Church today, surrounded by family and friends. We believe you've been blessed in the very first moment of your existence by the families that you've been born into. Today you'll be blessed in a special way as you begin life as husband and wife. So Sarah and John, you are about to celebrate this sacrament. having come here of your own free will and choice, and without compulsion to marry a child. Will you love and honor each other in marriage all the days of your life? And are you willing to continue being good and loving parents? I invite you now to pray before God and all of us your consent to become husband.
I swear to take you, John, as my husband, better for worse, a richer for sickness and health, to the
what God tries together, let no one separate. Lord, confirm the consent that you have given and enrich you with his blessings. Yes. Wise for action. We ask God to bless these things, that they will always be a reminder of a special and happy day.
John, where is sign right now? In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
What God joins together, let no one separate, and the Lord confirm the consent that you have given and enrich you with his blessings. And I think my next sad, happy duty is to pronounce you husband.
Thank you.
favor with his help, those of whom he has bestowed sacrifice of passion. Holy Father, made of the world, you created man and woman in your own image, and with our union in common to your blessing. We humbly beseech you for these your servants, who have joined today in sacrifice of passion. May you above the blessing of all come down upon this bright saint, and upon John, our companion for life. And may the power of your Holy Spirit set our hearts of flame from our fire, so that living out together the gift of passion, they may adorn their family with children and enrich the lives of those who are not. In happiness may they praise you, O Lord, and sorrow may they seek you out. May they have joy in your presence to help them in their trouble, and know that you are near to comfort them in their need. Let them praise you with the Holy Assembly, and bear witness to you, and after a happy old age together with a circle of friends and surroundings, may they come to the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord. And may the peace and the love of the Lord be with you all. So this is the sign of peace, so we want to indicate in some way, give each other a wave. We ask you for a smile, and we ask you too much. So often I need comfort. beautiful how to love one another, and that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and might always be yours. May you are truly blessed in your children, and have solace in your friends, and know true and lasting peace. And may Almighty God bless all of us, and keep us safe, safe on our roads, and the neighbors of home, and of the Son, and God, for the Holy Spirit. Our last event. Let us give thanks to God. And to the dogs, remember to share your pain.
Here this evening on this wonderful occasion, on this wonderful day for the celebration of Sarah and John's wedding reception. Yoo-hoo! You're alive, all right. You're alive, everybody. In particular this evening, I'm glad to welcome here to the top table, Cynthia and James. You're very welcome. Bill and Mary, you're very welcome. So it gives me great pleasure now to welcome our bridal party. They are very excited. So first of all, would you please give a warm welcome to Lorraine and John. Thank you.
Maria and David!
very good, wasn't it?
But you know what? You're going to have to do better for the next one.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to welcome our bride and groom. Would you please welcome Sarah and Joe? There's also separate ladies and gents and accessible toilets out the door on the left hand side. The last and most important thing, we have no fire drill planned for during the reception this evening. So, if you hear the alarm, and particularly if you hear the alarm and you see me running, will you kindly follow me? Ladies, don't worry about heels, I don't travel too fast. But the exits are to my right, to my left, down by the bar, and the door that you come into the room through. Our closest fire assembly point was here in the ballroom is in the Leisure Club car park, which is directly behind the top table. We also have an alternate fire assembly point in the main car park, out the front door and down to the right. Please God, we won't need it this evening anyway. Okay, so that's that bit done. We get proceedings moving. It is a pleasure and a privilege now for me to introduce our bride and groom to the official cutting of the cake. So I'm going to have that first of all. Mary's going to do a snap or two first of all. If anyone else wants to take a photograph after that, please feel free to come forward to do so. Because we're going to have some speeches then after that. Thank you.
Scotland. Well, after that, I don't know what to say. I'm like a priest of church, I don't know what to say. Anyway, we're doing something. Earlier this morning, I went up to a room. What I see was a beautiful girl, ready to get married. As you can see, I'm not over the shock. Now, I won't dwell too much on that because I can't. I know what's going to happen. Anyway, as I said, I want to thank everybody for your lovely presence. At lunchtime tomorrow, there's a surplus of ironing boards outside. You can all have them. Microwaves, take your pick. The other thing I want to talk about is I had a question for Sarah, and it's been buzzing around in my head for years. Since Sarah and John got together. Sarah said at one time, she was talking to her mother in the kitchen, girly talk. And she said, when I get married, I'd like to marry a man like my dad or my brothers. So Sarah, what in the name of Jesus are you doing there? I'll pay for that one later. Look, all I want to say is Sarah's my daughter, my favorite daughter, my only daughter, but she's my favorite daughter. And to herself and John, I want to wish them the best of luck. And may they be as happy as can be, for as long as can be. John is a little bit grumpy now and again, but John, I don't know. He's a great partner, great dad, husband. So we'll have a review of him in 6 months. Now, I would like to pay special tribute to 5 ladies on my right hand side. Who did? Trojan work. They organised everything this morning with Sarah. She didn't want to go to the church, she was screaming and crying in the room. Anyway, apart from that, they organised a fantastic stag. Now, I didn't make a mistake. It was a girl's stag. It was a real stag. Thank you, girls. Thank you. Unlike the mafia across the way there. Anyway, John has been welcomed into our family now. And I have a presentation to give him because he's a member of the Fields family now. And he has to accept it and he has to hold it up for a photograph. Before I finish, I just wanted to say that I'd like to pay a special tribute to 2 people in the room, to Sarah's mom, Mary. The lady you see today, she took her out of rehab, spent many a night in detox for her. That's the lady you see today. Thank you very much. And the next one I want to just thank, a very special thank you, is to a matchmaker, Jimmy Deborah. Without those 2 people, Mary and Jimmy, we wouldn't be here to see you. So a round of applause for Jimmy. missed out on the groomsmen. I'd like to say something about them, though. Something nice. I can't think of anything. That's me finished over and out. Thank you very much.
Great to meet Ben Rollo. John is absolutely sick here. You wouldn't believe it. You're washing his hands already under hooking that bill. Right, we're going to plow along. And we're going to change things up a little bit. What we're going to do is we're going to ask the mother of the groom to speak. No, I told you I won't do that.
Next speaker is going to be the father of the group, Jimmy Devereaux. Thanks very much, Michael. Ben, I don't know how to follow that, to be honest. You had me looking there as well, so you could expect anything now. I'm not as brave as you, let's say. I wrote everything out, so it's a pre-prepared statement. I'll be taking no questions afterwards on it. So here we go, I'm just going to read. Good afternoon, everyone. Hope you're all enjoying the day so far. For those of you who don't know me yet, I'm John's dad, Jimmy, and on behalf of my wife, Cynthia, and myself, or is it Sylvia, I'm not sure. Anyway, I'd like to say what a great pleasure it is to see you all here today to celebrate with John and Sarah on their big day. It's been a long time in the planning, but it's actually come around in the blink of an eye. I'd like to thank Monsignor Dan today. He's not here, but I think everyone enjoyed that wedding ceremony. I thought it was really good. The church are beautiful, thanks to Maria. All the lovely flowers. We're in a great hotel, lovely surrounding area, so we have no excuse for not enjoying ourselves today. Before I formally welcome Sarah to the Devereaux family, I just want to say how gorgeous she looks today. Sarah is a beautiful person inside and out, and she's a great credit to Ben, Mary, and all the Fields family. I firmly believe that people reflect what they've experienced in life themselves, especially growing up. And Sarah treats everyone with love and respect that can only have come from our own upbringing. To say I'm now welcoming Sarah to the family implies she was one of us already, but nothing could be further from the truth. Sarah is loved by us all and has been a big part of our family from day one. She's a brilliant mother to Amelia and Jake, and we couldn't ask for a more perfect fit for John. From the day they met up, they were like two sides of one coin, and were always destined to spend our lives together. Cynthia and I couldn't be prouder or happier to call Sarah our daughter-in-law. Before I go any further, I think it's only right to give a little bit of background to how John and Sarah met in the first place. I'm not going to say a huge amount, but all I'm going to say is it involved three lads starting out on a Saturday afternoon pub crawl, running into two women who were more than a few hours into a bottomless Prosecco deal at a pub in Nice. So what could go wrong? On the taxi ride to Nice, John, Michael and myself were asked by the driver what plans we had for the day. We told him we were going for a few pints in Nice. He told us he had collected two women killed earlier in the day that were going to Nice as well. He said they asked him, where in Ace would you recommend two women to go for a drink? Tesco's, he said. Just think, Sarah, we wouldn't be here today if you listened to that. Cynthia and I were blessed with five children, three girls and two boys, of which John is child number four. John spent the first 6 years of his life as the youngest child, but we made a point of never spoiling him. I guess what we're trying to say, Sarah, is he was perfect when he left us. John does have a few little quirks. I think it's only fair to tell you about them now. If he ever goes missing during the night, first place to check is the bath. He's partial to a kick in the bath from time to time. Another place to check would be behind the sofa. He's been known to hide there with the entire neighborhood out searching for him. Another tricky, you know, about this one he used to pull, was letting all the fall asleep into his dinner so he didn't have to eat it. Cynthia would carry him up to bed for a nap whenever he did that, but she struggled with that a bit recently. You may need a bit of help with that one, Sarah. In fairness to John, he's a model son and he has grown up to be a very principled man. To give you an example of those principles, we once went over to Leeds to watch the play Aston Villa. John, myself and Leeds fans for our trouble. Dave Mulvey, one of the groomsmen today, came with us. Take it out, Dave. And Dave is a Villa fan for his troubles. We went with a big group of lads that I grew up with, so it was a little bit of football mixed with copious amounts of beer. Our flight back was on the Sunday night and we all joined the queue at the gate for boarding. The flight out of Leeds that evening was full of football supporters of various other clubs, so there was plenty of light-hearted slagging going on. This seemed to upset one of the ground crew at the airport as he started to shout at everyone to quiet down. John turned around to the queue, put his fingers to his lips and went, shh. And everybody in queue started to do the same. This didn't sit too well with our friendly ground crew man who stormed off, only to return with a supervisor and a policeman. Hang on, take a big page for
it.
As we started the board, John was asked to step out of the queue, and I obviously stepped out with him. Dave, the Villa fan, kept his head down and boarded the plane. You won't be flying tonight, Sir John was told. Why, he asked. You're too drunk, they said. We argued for a while, but we're getting nowhere. Now, we've seen John drunk, and this most certainly wasn't a drunk John. The policeman stayed quiet, but when the ground crew left, he said, look, I can't interfere. I don't know why there's not a chin bar, but you seem fine to me. You'd be over the legal limit for driving if I breathalyzed you, though. I'm only a passenger looking to get home, said John. I don't have to fly to Olympia. The policeman laughed and said the best he could do was give us a lift to the nearest hotel. On the way out, he had to bring us back through passport control, and this is where John demonstrated his strong principles. As we were being waved through, John stopped and took out his passport. We don't need to see that, said the man on the desk. I insist, said John. As an Irishman, I'm not entering a foreign country without showing my passport. On principle, I insist you look at it. And my first thoughts were, oh no, we're going to be here for the duration. We're going to be like Tom Hanks' character, stuck in Leeds Bradford Airport for an eternity. Not being allowed in or out. It worked out in the end, though, and we finally got home on a Monday night. Dave, the Villa fan, got home the night before. All joking aside, John, you were a great son, brother, and friend. We all love you and are very proud of you. You were a brilliant dad to me and Jake, and we know you will always be a great husband to Sarah now, too. We wish you the best life ever together. And on that note, can I ask you all to please stand and raise a glass to the bride and groom, to John and Sarah. And just before you sit down, I'll break off from tradition here a little bit. John has a great bunch of friends. They treated him really well, looked after him when we were away on the stags. A lot of them are up here as groomsmen today. A lot are down around the guests. But I'm just going to ask you to raise a glass to the groomsmen and to Dave, the Villa fan. Thank you very much. Enjoy your day.
Right, that's another great speech there. Thanks very much. Now, we're halfway through. Oh, Amelia would like to give a speech now, so... I'm on the hook for a few minutes anyway. I'll get a few minutes off anyway. Take you something else to say, please.
John sitting on a tree. Okay.
chat back. John says, do you want to get married? Sarah says yes.
So far today. Yeah, she should have run my speech over there. A couple of chicken scratches on the pieces. Well, let's get started. A lot of you know me, a lot of you don't know me. I'm John's brother, Michael or Mick. Sue's with them, makes you happy. And John, me and John met back in 1987. He was a short, contentious, loud little shit. He was fond of a bottle. I mean, you look at him now, not much has changed really. I mean, he's gotten a little bit taller, but that's about it. Then, well, yeah, over the years, myself and John, obviously brothers, we kind of had a good brother relationship, except for one morning. I think John knows exactly what I'm talking about. Obviously, we shared a room. It would be a three-bed house, the two boys. We generally shared a room. I woke up in a folio room, which, it's not me at all. That wouldn't be me. So, I woke up and John had the audacity to say something to me. So I popped him right in the eye. Lovely black eye. How dare he say good morning to me? But to be fair to him, he actually took it in great spirits. He didn't try and hit me back. I mean, I was wearing twice his size. Twice his size now, but I wouldn't be hitting him. He took it in great spirits. And we had plenty of time to get me back. Saturday mornings in our house were a particularly good event. Let me talk to you. My dad was at work. Mom was in town. WWE was on the TV. We tore strips out of each other. And I mean, we tore strips. This is the type of thing where you break your arm and, luckily it never happened. We'd be like, no, you're okay, walk it off. But luckily, we didn't break furniture, we didn't break lamps. I don't know how we got away with it, but they were some of the best mornings ever. They really were. And again, it brings you closer as brothers. But I always remember kind of years later. I know you all think John a bit of a grump every now and again, but John is generally a very well-mannered person, always in a good mood. But this one particular day, he came into the kitchen and he had this just look on his face that he was just pissed off or something. But we were on him and at him and at him. Saying, what's wrong with you? What's wrong? Am I the only one not? There'll be a bad mood in this house. So we all just started laughing. Because, yeah, you're not allowed to be in a bad mood. But you're the only one that's never in a bad mood. But he cracked a smile after that, and it was all kind of forgotten about. But I'd like to move on and expand on something Jimmy there said about how John and Sarah met. And Alicia. Stand up there, please, if you don't mind. You do realise that if we kind of, well, we didn't go into that pub, but if you have to come over to us to talk up Sarah, this wouldn't happen. Like, regardless of who fixed who up and who decided to go to what pub, if you had to come over and talk to us, Sarah wouldn't come over and it wouldn't happen. So I'm assuming 50% of this is on you. I'm going to wrap this up now fairly shortly. I just wanted to talk about John and Sarah as a couple. And I know many of you know when you go up and visit them, the kids running around having a great time. They'll sit with you, they'll talk with you, make you a cup of tea. Sarah will just cook and cook and cook and cook and cook. My God, the woman feed an army. That's just me. But two people better suited, I have never seen. I really haven't. It happens. Can we put up? Oh, yeah. One more thing. Sorry. I want to mention Paul, Lee, Mull, Frank. Lads, this wouldn't have happened. It was stag do, in fucking stuff without the lot of you. I am the best man. These are the best men. No doubt about it. I wouldn't do any of this. Can't do anything coming together. So, I'm going to be the first to raise a glass. Did I groove it? Now, moving on to the girls. Ladies, with the Gladia for the horse up today, and from what Sarah's been saying about it, from what John's been telling you, absolutely fantastic friends to Sarah. He gave her a great time over in Spain. Yes, somewhere in Spain.
Santa Ponza.
Santa Ponza, thank you. But she took not talk any better of you girls. And she is so happy to have you here. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, raise the glass for the bridesmaids. Now, this is me signing off. We've all talked about them. We've all given a bit of abuse. It's time to hear from the man himself. Signing his name, and he appears, I believe, in John Pedro. This looks long. It's not long. I was supposed to be scrolling. Good evening, folks. Thanks for coming here today and spending your hard-earned cash with us. Sorry, I've been told that I'm only getting to do this once, so I want to get it right. On behalf of myself and my beautiful wife, I've been dwelling beyond the Woodlands Hotel in Adair, and thank you all for being here. I know wedding invitation at times can seem like a bit of a summons, you know. There's suits, there's dresses, there's cards. It's a whole to do. So again, extend our gratitude for everyone being here. We really appreciate it. We have guests that have travelled from far and wide. We have people from Scotland. Yeah. People from Valencia. Yeah. We have people from Dublin, from Cork. From Gilmair and even as far away as Shannon. Yeah. You put it on the location. If you haven't been there, you have to go. So, I'd like to start off with thanking you. hopefully in the center of the parents. So for us, for Mary and Ben, from the moment the message broke, you've been nothing but welcoming, generous and supportive of both myself and Sarah. I kept myself extremely lucky to be gaining the best in-laws a man could ever ask for. Not only have you been supporting and generous, you're actually friends. You're more than that. Now, that being said, we do feel this is all an act, just that. So they don't send her back. You were a bit too willing to give her away then. All serious though, and Sarah, you've raised an absolute gem. Like, her values, her loyalty, her generosity, everything that she is comes from you. And to me, you've given an amazing gift. And believe me, it's a gift that I cannot wait to unwrap later on. Physically today, but myself and Sarah lost family and friends who were very dear to us. And although they may not be sat here with us, they're with us in spirit. So I'd like to raise a glass. And gone, but not forgotten. Finally, on the way, beautiful new wife, Sarah. Just for me to do, I can make a contact to see how many days after a tour, yeah? You're an absolute vision. A vision today. Pure beauty. You always look great, but my God. Today. The jaw dropped. The head dropped. The physical dropped. So, it's been spoken about already, but it should come now as no surprise to everybody that me and Sarah met in a pub. Shock horror. So we get talking to my dad. One little lie about saving for a mortgage effectively changed my life. Now Sarah doesn't lie often, but when she does, it tends to have life-changing effects. I was also told she couldn't get pregnant. Two beautiful children later. I think we can all. We can all agree that I'm being had there. Honestly, though, Sarah, you have completed me as a person. I know I'm the luckiest man on earth to be able to call you my wife. I've known that I wanted to spend the rest of my life with you from very early on in our relationship, as Ben can attest to. Happened in one of Robbie's camper vans. And the fact that I fell asleep on the sofa very early that day and had Ben write all over my face and marker does not negate that I meant them words. You're the kindest, most thoughtful, most generous and most beautiful woman I could ever ask for. I love every part of you. On top of all this, you're the most amazing mother to two wonderful children, Amelia and Jake. The joyful and fun nature that they have is a reflection of what you have given them. But then again, so is their tantrums. Cannot wait to continue our journey together for the rest of our lives, to face down any challenges we encounter, to enjoy every journey we embark on, and to treasure every moment we have together. I love you with all my heart. I just like to wrap up with a quick toast and all that you're saying. So if everyone could be upstanding and all that glass. Slán a quick affair August Gomarfig Gumana good Joe. So health to the men and may the women live forever. Finish off now, and it's time for dinner. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. And once again, bride and groom.
Sunday, when Thanks for joining us. We're going to make that for everyone to see Hopwood for tonight.